Does he do photography tutorials? Does he do tech videos? Does he review memes? Well, I don't know about any of that, but what I can tell you for sure is this video isn't related to any one of them. I know I look like shit, and the only reason I'm uploading this video is
because I'm a stud. I'm ballsy. I don't take no shit from anyone.
Today we're going to be reviewing one of the more horrible pieces of tech that I found on Amazon, which is the Cosmic Byte Nebula 2.4 GHz wireless connectivity. Yeah, that's it for the intro. So this is a controller that you can buy for around 1500 rupees on Amazon.in. This boasts a connectivity of up to 8 meters over the 2.4 GHz frequency, and it comes with a dongle and an OTG adapter in case you wanted to connect to your smartphone. Now initially what I do is I buy the product and I don't care to review it at all, not certainly in a form of a video, but given the fact that this controller has pissed me off over the past week or so, this video is sort of my response to shitty companies who make these products. I mean, I'm sure their intent was really good since this is one of the cheapest controllers that you can find on Amazon.com. But still, that doesn't mean that the hideous quality of the controller is justified by the price. Now, starting off by mentioning the features, this controller offers you backlit XYAB keys along with a green indicator having four LEDs, which I would be talking about later in the video. Now, analyzing the pros and cons of this controller, I would first like to start with the pros of this controller since the list is shorter than you might expect. Now, first thing that I like to mention is the color scheme on this controller. The controller really has a good color scheme. I really dig this black and green color scheme that it has going on along with all the indicators and the good amount of light that comes out of the backlit XYAB keys, which leads to my second point, which is the backlit system is really good on this that they have going on in here along with all the indicators and stuff. I have a complaint regarding the indicators that they have around the CB logo, the green four LEDs that they have, but I would be covering that in the con section. The third and the last point when it comes to the pros of this controller is the whole gaming look that it manages to achieve because of the whole analog stick layout along with the good color scheme that they have along with the backlit. So this doesn't really feel like a 1500 rupee controller when you first look at it. That is until you start using the controller, which brings me to the cons of this controller. Now before I start with the cons of this controller, I would first like to meet the person who designed slash programmed slash did whatever with this controller that made the controller into what it is, which is the fact that because of the fact that there are four LEDs on this controller, and there's something I would like to ask you, whoever you are in a Cosmic Byte's company. Why
are you gay?
Who says I'm gay?
You are gay. How can I describe you?
I mean, for those of you who don't know, there are four LEDs. There are four LED lights on this controller which actually blink really fast when the controller is trying to find the host device to pair with, and after it is done pairing, wait, I'll show you in a minute. So as soon as the controller has detected a successful connection with the PC, the lights go stable. There is only one LED
that lights up,
and after that it is just stable. You could have made it into where it actually indicates the battery. It would have been a lot easier for the person who's gaming on this controller to charge the controller timely, since having just one LED on at all times doesn't really help when it comes to knowing how much battery you have left. Now this brings me to the first point when it comes to the cons of this controller. That's right, the rant you just heard was just me easing you in into the con section. We have just started.
Are you ready?
Now, although the build quality of this controller seems really, really nice for the price you actually pay for it, that is 1500 rupees, but considering the quality of the keys, I would call it serviceable, but that is until you realize that this controller has the shittiest pair of bumper keys that you would ever find on a controller. I actually would show you a controller that is 1000 rupees wired controller, which actually performs and feels better to actually play with. Now this may be nitpicking at this point, but I would like to mention this: the honor switch, the quality of honor switch on this controller is
severe and continuous lapse in my judgment.
It actually is a sliding mechanism, left to right sliding mechanism if you look at it. And if you try to slide it left, it sometimes jams in between. And something like an on-off switch is really, really basic, and they could have done better when it comes to the clickiness of the switch and the amount of force that you actually have to apply for the switch to go from right to left and vice versa. Now coming to my point number two is the tactility of the buttons. Again, as I talked in the quality section, the tactility of the buttons, all of the buttons is sort of fine. The buttons are really mushy, I would say though, and it takes a significant amount of force for you to actually end up clicking the analog sticks, considering the amount of running you have to do in FPS games these days due to the huge maps. I was playing Far Cry 5. And due to the fact that the controller has horrible ergonomics, I found it really, really tiring in my 1 to 2 hour gaming session, which made me switch to keyboard and mouse real fast. I would here like to address the tactility of the bumper buttons. The bumper buttons have horrible stability. As you can see, I'm able to move both the bumper buttons, the keycaps of both the bumper buttons, just by putting my finger and vibrating it a little bit. And because of this, it isn't a pleasant experience pressing this bumper button, since even if I press the bumper button, I can still move my finger. The button stability, as horrible as it is, the tactility is even more horrible. So again, if you press the bumper button from this side, you can see the bumper button has gone in, but you can actually press the bumper button from this side as well, which actually is something that makes the key sort of unusable for me, because of the fact that the bumper button would actually not register your command. Sometimes even if the button is pressed, it would actually unregister the command without you even knowing. So I was playing Hellblade with this a couple of days ago, and the default controls on Hellblade is you walk with this, you walk forward with this, and you actually run with the bumper button. And in the middle of the game, the character stopped running or started just walking normally, and I didn't understand. But as I realized that you have to press this button somewhat hard for it to actually continuously register your command, which is again contributing towards making this controller really, really unusable. And the reason you don't see me smashing this controller on my pink wall, it's because of the fact that I have to return this and get a new one, probably a Readgear Pro wireless. Now last but not the least is the connectivity of the controller.
Oh, my favorite part of the review.
You know, when you buy these really cheap controllers for like $4 to $5, I don't know how cheap controllers are in your country. This is just like that, but even more annoying. So the fact that this controller actually disconnects 10 to 15 times during my 2 to 3 hour gaming session is something really amazing. And never did I think that a controller could bring me to a point of actually killing myself when it comes to the bumper buttons and the actual connectivity of this piece of shit. So as I was saying, I was playing Hellblade, and during my 2 to 3 hour gaming session of playing Hellblade, this controller disconnected more times than your ex has told you that there's nothing going on between her and her best friend. Now this led me to research on the internet why this controller was disconnecting, and I stumbled upon a review on Amazon which told people to actually connect the controller's USB nano receiver to the PC's USB straight away, as opposed to a USB hub or dock. But I figured out that this is an issue with the non-powered USB hubs, and since I had a powered USB hub, I won't face this issue. But after 15 to 20 minutes, I was like, oh shit, the reviewer was right. And this prompted me to take out the USB nano receiver from the powered USB hub that I had and plugging it into the USB of the PC itself. After which, again, it worked fine for 5 to 10 minutes, I guess. And for those of you who are wondering that I might have a low battery on this, I had this charging for around 5 to 6 hours prior to my testing. So as I was saying, I had the USB nano receiver plugged into the PC's USB, and then I thought to myself that if it isn't working right now, it might be the case that I have to plug the USB nano receiver into the motherboard's USB port. Even at the time that I had this idea, I knew that taking the nano receiver out of my PC's front I/O panel and plugging it at the back of my PC into the motherboard's own I/O panel wouldn't really help and didn't make any sense. But so does you acting emotionally broken on Snapchat and Insta stories
while you have 40 other shoulders to cry on.
Back to the controller. So I ended up taking the nano receiver out of my PC's front I/O and plugging it into the back of the motherboard in hopes of it actually working better or actually working altogether. And to my surprise, actually it did fuck all for me, and my controller started disconnecting. So I don't think that there is any way I could get this to work. It boasts a connectivity of around 8 meters as far as I know, but from where I play to where is my setup is, the distance is around 4 to 5 meters, and I wasn't able to get stable connectivity there as well. This is a controller that I got from a company called Speedlink, and I actually bought it for 1,000 rupees, and man, I regret not buying the wireless version of this controller at the time. The bumper buttons on this one is actually good. No matter where you press it from, it actually actuates well and registers your command really, really well. So I guess in closing, what I would like to say is don't believe everything you see on the internet and even the reviewers. I'm not saying that the Amazon reviews were fake, but even the reviews that were on the Amazon were not totally helping me out in this case. But I hope I was able to inform you guys, the ones who are looking to buy this controller, about the negatives of this controller as opposed to the positives, since I found positives to be minimal with this controller. So yeah guys, if you like this informal sort of type of review that I had going on in this video, do consider leaving a like and subscribe to my channel. But if you expected this video to be funny,
don't give a fuck what Eddie says. Who gives a fuck? I run New York City! I'm a fucking pimp!
Thanks a ton guys for sticking around till the end of this video. Like I said, if you found this video useful and not just like any other review, do consider leaving a thumbs up and subscribing to the channel. The links to my social media are given down in the description, and I'll see you guys in the next video.